of the relationship between our country and China. And the question is, what do we make of what is now happening in China with respect to the imprisonment of people who dare tell the truth, who dare on the internet to type what to most of us would seem to be a very innocent email and discover it puts them 10 or 20 years in a Chinese prison? What do we make of all that? And can we sense of human rights? For example, just a few days ago, the Uyghur journalist, editor of a popular website, was sentenced to 15 years in prison in China for apparently giving an interview to the foreign media after the July 2009 demonstrations and riots. We have a distinguished panel of witnesses who will help us examine whether of political prisoners in China. Our commission believes that to promote the rule of law in China, it is vital to publicize and seek the release of these people. It was international pressure that played a critical role in securing the freedom of Nelson Mandela. That new society in these countries will be led by people who understand a great respect and exercise a great respect for human rights. Let me conclude by saying that China is an extraordinary country. Perhaps most of us in this room have visited China. And we look at this very large, interesting country with an extraordinary history, with wide-eyed interest, and we understand it will play a significant part of the lives of our country and the world in decades.
Not only those who suffer criminal prosecution, conviction, and sentence to jail, but those who don't, but who are also prisoners in many significant ways. Now, the Chinese government always denies that it has any political prosecution. People are always prosecuted for violating specific provisions of the criminal law. But the criminal law, as we all know,
charges stem from his efforts to gain the release of his brothers who had fallen afoul of local officials.